Hey, welcome back to the channel. My name is Kyle Martin, and I'm walking down the driveway with my dog, Porter. I just got back today from the Des Moines, Iowa skate park, and it's the largest skate park in the United States. A lot of interesting things happened, and I vlogged the whole time, and we got a lot of really excellent skateboarding done. We met a lot of really cool people down there as well. We ate at Zombie Burger. We checked out Subsuck Skate Shop. We just kind of had a summer skateboarding vacation, which neither one of us have done in at least for 10 years or so. So in today's video, instead of the usual en plein air painting videos, we're gonna flashback to last winter and we're gonna head up into my studio. We're gonna be creating a painting of the golden hour light falling onto a building on Williamson Street in Madison. This is kind of a different painting video because this video is gonna show an indirect technique, and it's a way that I don't normally work, but it's fun to try out a lot of different things, and so that's what this video is gonna be all about. Anyway, I hope everybody's doing well. I hope you have a good weekend. And I'm just gonna be relaxing for the rest of my night because we've been out skateboarding 6 hours yesterday, 3 hours today, and I don't know, these mosquitoes are killing me. Let's head up to the studio and let's create this painting of Williamson Street. Right here I'm breaking the photo reference down into shapes of value. I'm using some different colored markers, but I'm really focused on the values that I'm going to be using in the painting. There you can see some of the values that are represented by those colors on the marker sketch. I'm taking my time at this point. And I probably spent an hour or an hour and a half making a drawing. This is waterproof ink thinned with water. So I'm just checking the consistency of the ink. And my goal with this was to have something that was transparent and could be layered. One layer of transparency over another layer to create and build up some of the darks that I was going to be using in the painting. This is an indirect painting technique. I don't normally start my paintings by creating an underpainting with black ink, but I'm also not opposed to it, and it's kind of fun to experiment with different techniques. The benefit of using indirect techniques is that you can resolve the drawing issues before you move on and use any color. Sometimes I'm in the mood to do something like that, and that's what was happening during this painting session. I'm really starting to build this painting up. I'm definitely referring to my marker sketch as I'm doing this, but most of all, I'm just using a lot of ink and letting it drip down and having a good time. And I'm using some transparent colors of oil paint that have been thinned with painting solvent that make them even more transparent. I'm kind of adding a glaze to this painting. I'm gonna let that glaze dry overnight, and the goal is to come back the next day and add some more opaque paint and resolve everything that's all the way on the canvas. We're moving into the second day, and I'm spending a little bit of time before I start painting for the day, just warming up my arm, warming up my eye. It looks like I grabbed some kind of a blue pastel out of my box of pastels, and I just took a little bit of time and recreated the image that I'm working from in pastel. I really want to clean that palette off and use it again sometime soon. It looks fun to be laying out all these big globs of paint. Of course, Porter is at my side in the studio.
He'd probably rather be going on a walk. Starting to mix up some colors I'm going to use in the painting. I'm probably mixing them to specific values. The lens is a little dirty in this shot, but you can see I have my little value palette off to the side of the painting. And during this session, it's just time to have a little bit of fun. You can see I'm adding those reflections onto the cars. Those ended up being some really cool colors. I've got a chip brush there, just like a 2-inch wide brush from the hardware store that I laid in some information into the shadow tones. I can remember the sky was a lot of fun. It looks like I'm just kind of pixelating some colors in, adding some color here. I'm not really going off of the true colors of the photograph or anything like that. I'm more interpreting what I was feeling on that evening as Corbin and I walked down the street in Williamson as the sun was setting. I wanted to lose a lot of the edges in the shadows, so a lot of the shapes in the shadow side of the painting are just kind of there for a moment, and then they're not there at the same time. Overall, I think that this is an interesting technique to explore. I'm actually working on one in the studio right now that is utilizing this technique. I haven't painted this way since I created this painting in December of last year. I think I'll enjoy working in that way again in the future.
Thanks so much for checking in on this video. We'll be back with more soon. Have a good weekend.
I'll be back next week with another upload, and I appreciate you being here. Have a good weekend.